Of some legends of Motown. So we're doing a really special segment. And you're very special to me also because you're part of the first radio broadcast. We're actually sitting in the television studio right now. How you guys doing?
We're doing great.
Good.
Yes. So excited. Lamont Dozier Jr. and the fabulous Beth Griffith. This is going to be great. We're going to be going live in a second for the television show. And this is just amazing. I always do my mirror thing, but I'm going to wait till the cameras come on. So we can do that little
I might need to borrow that from you.
Right, exactly. I'm going to pass you that.
Let me know.
Hey, everybody. It's Davi Davenport. You're tuning in to Davi Davenport Live. I'm so excited. I have two amazing for the radio. I've got the radio show going on today also, so you're getting a double shot whammy here for all my radio friends. This is the most amazing, one of the most amazing segments that I've done here on Channel 36. I have two of the children of two amazing Motown legends, actually Lamont Dozier Sr. and Johnny Griffith, two fantastic artists. I have their children here with me today. I have Beth Griffith and I have Lamont Dozier Jr. And I'm making sure, because I get a little tongue-tied, but I'm making sure, you know, shows like this are really important to me because I was raised on the Motown music. You know, I was raised with things like this. So I wanted you, because Davi Davenport Live is all about, make sure my hair's all fleek, as the kids say. Davi Davenport Live is all about me bringing you people, places, and things that are really, really exciting. And this isn't the show that I'm sure a lot of you that already tune in know. This is not the show to tune into if you want to hear somebody get bashed. This is the show that you tune into if you want to hear people spread love and excitement. Oh, we get crazy. You already know that. But this is the show that we actually, I actually just asked Lamont, what do you want me to talk about? Tell me some of the things that we'd like to talk about. I asked Beth the same thing. So I'd like to introduce you to two of the most amazing performers that are on this planet today.
Oh, wow.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Debbie, how are you?
What's going
on? Thank you. That was awesome.
Glad to be here.
I know. I was like, hey, let me lead up to that.
Wow.
First of all, I have to thank you for coming out.
Thank you. We're glad to be here.
Thank you for coming out. I know you have a huge show tomorrow, which we're going to tell the viewers a little bit more in a bit, but you have a huge show at Sheila E's E-Spot.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I love that place.
Yes, it's beautiful.
Yeah,
it really is so amazing. We're really excited. I hear that you have a sold-out show.
Oh, well, fantastic.
Look at that. That is like, hey.
Fantastic.
I love that you brought your mother and your husband.
Yes.
That's amazing. Your mother's gorgeous. Your husband's
you.
A cutie pie, too,
thank
girl.
You.
I had to get that one out, too.
Oh, I'm sure
he's like, he already knows, honey. Tell me about, first of all, again, I said welcome to the city. Tell me about being kids of legends. I just want to lead in with that because that's what's exciting. Robin, talk to me about you coming, and I got so excited. She said, I don't see it excited. So, I mean, it's definitely excites me. I mean, I get excited. But, I mean, just because I grew up on Motown music. I grew up. So I'm going to start with you, Lamont. I usually say ladies first, but you know, as pretty as she is, I'm going to give her a whole bunch of time.
Thank you.
Tell me about being raised by a legend.
Well, I tell you, you know, it's really special, but then it's normal, you know, for when you come up in that atmosphere, for you, you know, it's just your life. But then you grow older and you find out what your parents do is a very public profession. Mm-hmm. And as I got older and I began to appreciate what my father did in the industry, you know, I have to look back with awe because they accomplished a lot of things over their musical, you know, legacy. And I want to tell you something, all the hits and everything like that they've produced and written, it was overwhelming, you know. But for me, you know, it left some big shoes to fill, and I'm very excited.
Did you know at a young age that you wanted to
yes.
be in the industry?
Yes, I did. Yes, I did. I was exposed to music at a very young age. I went to many a recording session. You know, I got a chance to see a lot of musicians do their craft in person. And next thing I know, they'd be on the radio, and it hit me in a very powerful way. And I said, I want to do this for a living.
Yes,
you know, so
yes. And Beth, what about you?
Wow, my household was very normal.
Okay.
My mother was a teacher, elementary guidance school counselor. My
girl, what's normal?
Well,
I said, somebody show me normal, I'm going to take a picture of it. I want to see normal.
Well, people have this perception that if your parent is an entertainer, there's these parties going on in your house.
Yes.
You know, and it's not that. I had curfews. I ate my vegetables. I had to do my homework before I went outside.
Hold on 1 second. Can you bring that camera up for me just a little bit on top of their heads, just a little bit? This is live television for anyone that's tuning in. That's how I do it. If I see something I need corrected, I correct it. Bring it up just a little bit. We're a little bit on top of their heads. Okay, for me, Axel? Thank you, sweetheart. All right, baby. I just have to make sure everything's perfect.
They cut me off.
Hello? I was like, wait a minute. They on top of my boo's head. Hold on. We ain't doing it like
all this hair. They got to see.
And for anybody tuning in on the radio, that's right. This is Debbie Davenport live. That's what Robin said the other day. You live, honey. It's okay. Live. We do what we do.
Right.
Go ahead.
No, but it was pretty normal. The one thing I do remember is my dad always, we had a beautiful grand piano in our home, and my dad always played and practiced the chromatic scale all the time. And for the longest time, I did not know that my father worked for Motown. I thought my father didn't have a job, and all he did was play the piano. So people said, what does your daddy do? And I said, well, he just plays piano all day because he picked me up.
Your daddy worked for Motown, and you didn't?
I did.
For a long time, I just like, geez, I thought he was, he didn't.
I mean, honestly, my father didn't want me in the business. Okay. I did not know my father was a funk brother.
Oh,
I did
wow.
not know. But, you know, that was how my household was. It was just, my mom, my dad,
a lot of
my
times,
brother.
You know, I interact with a lot of different performers, young performers now that talk about, you know, that their parents want to keep them away from it.
Mm-hmm.
And especially in the days that we're in now with the paparazzi
right. mm-hmm.
and the lack of any privacy.
Yeah.
And I think, and I appreciate
we
what
didn't
you
have
said.
The internet and all that stuff.
Oh,
yeah,
so.
It was a different time. Yeah. Yes,
yes,
definitely.
Yes. One of the things that, just speaking of social media and, you know, the past years in the record industry, what do you think about the difference of how people are? Because in the days of Motown and the days of past music, you really had to be talented.
Yes.
You know, there wasn't auto tunes or what is it called? Is that called? Mm-hmm. No, what is it called? Auto what?
Yeah, auto-tune.
Auto-tune.
Yes, yeah, you got it right, David.
You got it. Auto tunes and all
yes.
that. You had to sing.
Yes.
You know, so when you hear some of the people, then they perform live.
Mm.
We were raised on live music.
Yes.
We were raised on it.
Yes.
So you were speaking about, okay, so there's two different dynamics here. You kind of lived in an environment, didn't even know your father worked for Motown, thought he was.
Didn't have a job. Right.
Yes.
On the other hand, you knew for a fact, you were raised right with it, knew
yes.
for a fact it was all around you at all times, and yet and still you both are sitting here today.
Well, I think our audience also needs to know my mom was at Motown before my father was.
Doing what?
She was working in the marketing and advertising department at Motown.
Okay.
Very small room with one of Berry Gordy's sisters.
Oh, really?
So she was there before he got there. He, at the time, was a very young artist signed to one of Berry's sister's labels, Anna Records, okay?
Mm.
And Anna Records was a label that was affiliated with Motown, but my father was signed there first under the name Lamont Anthony. And he started as a teenager. Yeah, he had an alias. And he was singing there, and he wanted to come over to Motown, and my mom was very influential and pivotal in getting him over to Motown because she was already there.
Okay.
And Berry at the time, he wanted his songwriters to write in tandem with other songwriters. And so he paired them up with Freddie Gorman and Brian Holland.
Okay.
And then they started to write, and then Eddie came into the picture, and then they became Holland Dozier Holland.
So you that's know. Your father's claim to fame.
Yes.
His writing.
Yes, his writing. But he was a singer first. He was a singer. He was in a group with Leon Ware and Tyrone Hunter and Marvin Gaye.
Marvin Gaye.
Yes, it was beautiful. But then they all came over to Motown eventually. But he made his mark as a songwriter.
Maybe Gordy really knew how to put together. Talk about building a musical empire.
Yes.
And bringing very authentic talent. You know, when I think about the music that I was raised on and the music that really spoke to my heart.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And that's what, you know, actually I got some links to some of your music and that's exactly what I heard from both of you.
Oh, thank you.
I heard very, and I really think that's from being raised by two very real entertainers.
Oh, yeah.
Well, my dad was classically trained.
Yes.
On the piano. So he was a real musician who could read music.
Okay.
And in his later years, he went to be an accompanist for Detroit Public Schools. So he taught music, he taught piano, and he was a real musician.
Wow. Yeah.
He didn't just play by ear.
Right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I commend people that do. I commend
these people.
People say they've never had a class in their life. They don't know how to read music and all that. But when you think about people, my grandmother's a classical pianist.
Wow.
She's 99
yes.
years old.
Oh, bless her.
Wow.
Yeah, she's
wow.
an amazing, amazing. You guys have been touring. I hear that you've been on the road just doing all kind of crazy things. I mean,
well, don't say that.
No, not crazy things.
Look,
she's like, my husband.
Is that
real money? Don't be saying it was too crazy.
Right, though.
No, but just a lot of, on the road with Kim.
Yes. And he's actually signed to Motown Records, which is awesome. But I've been working with him for, it'll be 3 years this year.
Okay.
And been touring with him. And we just completed, I think, a 26-plus city tour with Charlie Wilson and Joe. And
26.
I was gone for 7 weeks.
7 weeks?
And they've just added 15 more cities, so I'll be gone for another month.
Somebody's I know what y'all did when you got home, baby.
Wait,
I know what went on up in that. I should have been a fly on that wall.
My mom.
Oh, mommy, I'm sorry.
But we're married. So
but you're just married. Right. But just married, but so you can married. Do that.
Yeah, so they've just added 15 more cities. We'll be gone for another month.
Okay.
And road life is interesting.
Do you have any children?
No.
Not yet. Okay.
See, I toured with Anita Baker for about 5 years, okay. But the touring was different.
Okay.
She toured on the weekend, and I was home during the week. Okay. This was just consistent, gone for 7 weeks. So it was different. It was a learning experience for me.
Sure.
As well. But it was fun. It was
sure
a lot of fun.
Sure, they were lucky. So you were doing background vocals.
Yes, yes.
Awesome. Yes. Awesome. Mm-hmm. What about you, Lamont?
Well, I've been this working musician in L.A., you know, doing sessions and killing them in the nightclubs as best as I can.
Oh, really?
And just bringing back that organic experience of putting people in the room with live entertainment. I've been doing that for almost 10 years here in Los Angeles. Oh, you could have caught me at Cafe Cordial, which is about to close, but it was a great spot. Okay. Catalina Jazz on Sunset.
Yes, Robin took me
I did
there.
A 2-year stint at Beverly Hills Hotel.
Ooh-hoo.
At Bar 1912, so you may have seen me there. We had
Whitney,
great times, you know.
Rest in peace, yeah. Whitney. That's where she took her last breath.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah. So, you know, I'm still performing, and tomorrow with Beth Griffin, it's going to be a great show.
Sheila E. has really been doing some, I mean, she has really been strategically booking the talent in such a beautiful way. I was just there the other day with Legally Blind.
Yes.
They're amazing.
Yes,
I was
they
there
are.
Last month with Stephanie Spruill.
Yes.
In fact, Stephanie, if you're out there and you're tuning in, I've got her book right here.
Yes, she's amazing.
Love Stephanie. Yes. 17 points of longevity in the business. Mm-hmm. Love her, love her. But I really think, I appreciate the way that Sheila's thinking about, because a lot of times venues just bring whoever in.
Mm-hmm. Right, right.
Even if they sell a ticket or they bring them in and they're not thinking. So I like what she's doing with that. That's
well,
amazing.
I like the aspect of live music. It puts you in the room in an intimate setting, yes. Up close, mm-hmm. with very talented people. So there's no trickery going on. A bogus,
no auto-tune.
No auto-tune or anything like that.
So, there's no lip singing.
No.
So when you can see these national, international acts come in up close,
yes.
and do their craft.
Yes.
You know, it's magic with that. And
yes.
so me and Beth, we're going to do a little magic tomorrow yes. at our show.
So you're going to be, are you singing any songs that you have together, or is it going to be individual songs that you're doing? What's the?
Should we tell them?
Tell me a little. Tell me, tell the viewers and everyone on the radio show a little. This is Dobby 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 Live.
A little hint. We'll be doing some individual.
Yes.
And some things together.
Okay.
As well as some original music for both of us. So we're excited about that.
Awesome.
Yeah.
I see you have a wedding ring on your finger as well.
And my beautiful wife.
Where's
she's
your
in the
beautiful
studio.
Wife? Was that the one that just brought
Yeah, she sure
oh
did.
My
she,
God,
she,
beautiful
she got you the pen. And she's, that's what she does. She sold.
I should have known.
You know,
I said, who is that extra beautiful woman? extra beautiful. I knew you and I, and Robin and Kaz and the big, my Virginia.
Extra
like, wait a minute.
Beautiful.
Like, what
yes.
extra beautiful?
Yes.
Absolutely. Congratulations.
Yes.
I'm
well,
a family
know.
Person.
Yes.
That's why.
Oh, I believe.